Hi, I'm Carly, and welcome back to MHN Season 6, and this is School Announcements, where I'll be giving you all the latest news on MHS and fill you in on what you might be missing during the daily announcements every week. Prom is on May 7th. There will be an assembly in the gym Monday, May 3rd, for all students attending the prom from 12:30 p.m. to 1 p.m. There will be time given for questions and answers at that time. Stay on top of your Term 4 grades. Homework club will be in person in C201 or on a Google Meet. If you are remote and want to join, just send an email to Ms. Girondo. The next international club meeting is May 5th at 2:15 in room B225. The next Saga club meeting will be May 12th at 2:15 in room B225 as well. Contact Ms. Adams for a link to join virtually if you are working remotely. The class of 2024 is having a raffle for Mother's Day flower bouquets. The first prize will receive a large floral arrangement and vase. The second and third prizes will receive wrapped cut flower bouquets. The arrangements are from the flower pot. Winners will be drawn and contacted by Friday, May 7th so that the flowers can be delivered in time for Mother's Day. Raffle tickets are on sale now and can be purchased from Ms. Petrosky, Ms. Sullivan, or any of the freshman class officers. The cost is $3 for one ticket or $10 for four tickets. Cash or check made out to MHS Class of 2024 can also be sent to Ms. Petrosky or Ms. Sullivan at the high school. If you are looking to guarantee your Mother's Day gift, we are also selling succulents for $6 per plant. Succulents can be purchased from Ms. Sullivan in room A102 before or after school during flex block and lunch. Thanks for watching.
Hi everyone, I'm Connor. As of April 26th, all students are back in school 5 days, but there are some changes like the dividers in the lunchroom and keeping your distance in class. This week's MHN special report, I will be asking students on their thoughts on coming back to school.
I'm here with Will Stack. Will, are you excited on coming back to school?
Yes, I'm very excited to see all my friends.
Thank you, Will. I'm here with Michael and the Daminator. Guys, how do you feel on coming back to school?
Great.
It's awesome.
I am here with star of the soccer team, Diego Pinto. Diego, what are your thoughts on coming back to school so far?
Me personally, I really enjoy coming back to school. Working at home, like doing school at home, it's just a lot of distractions and stuff. And I personally just like seeing my friends every day and just not being home. Because being home just kind of like got sad, you know, just like always chilling in one room for like 6 hours. It just wasn't it, you know.
Inspirational stuff. Thanks, Diego. I'm here with Abrao. Abrao, what are your thoughts on coming back to school?
Good seeing everybody back, you know. Good.
Yeah, thanks, Abrao.
No problem, bro.
I'm here with Amani. Amani, what are your thoughts on coming back to school so far?
I'm happy to see my friends. It's not as bad as I thought it would be, but I'm having fun.
Do you think we should have came back sooner or later? Or not at all?
I think we came at the right time. Maybe a little earlier would have been fine, but I'm good with it.
So far, has coming back to school been easier or harder, or has it even affected you at all?
It's been pretty easy. I thought it would be hard, but I'm having a good time. Not bad.
Thank you for your time, Amani.
All students are happy to be in school for the first time since last March in Seattle.
Hello, my name's Sean.
And I am Aiden.
And this is MHS Sports on MHN. Football has come to an end.
The boys had a great season, and it ended 3-3.
Their most recent games included an 18-14 win against Groton and a 21-14 loss against St. Bernard. Go Tigers!
Thank you, seniors, for a great effort.
I'm Jake.
I'm Tyler.
And you're watching Hype City.
Counting double-digit thousands.
And this week's a little different. We're going to be reviewing movies that are coming out for you guys.
This week, I'm going to be reviewing Kong vs. Godzilla. which was a movie that came out March 31st, so about a month ago. And I actually watched this movie about 2 weeks ago with my girlfriend, and it was actually really action-packed. It was interesting. I give it a 9 out of 10. My favorite part about it was probably when they just fought. I don't know. It was just kind of interesting.
It's Godzilla.
The next movie is Mortal Kombat. It came out April 16th, 2021. And the reviews so far have not been too good, but I'm optimistic because the movie was a video game before it became a film. So I think that'll draw a lot of attention to the film. And a couple actors that are in the movie are named Joe Taslim and Louis Tan.
Yeah, I saw the trailer for that movie. It actually looked really interesting. Like, but now I don't really want to watch it because of the reviews, but I might still give it a try.
Yeah, I'm optimistic about it. I'm still going to watch it, yeah.
These are your champions.
I'm Sonya. That's Kano.
I'm Liu Kang.
Name's Jax.
Kung Lao.
Lord Raiden.
The fate of Earth is in our hands.
Hello everyone, welcome back to Living That in the Kitchen. You might be wondering where my partner Natalie is, who usually stands right here. And today we're actually gonna do something special. I am going to be baking chocolate chip cookies without a recipe, totally eyeballing all the ingredients. And then I'm gonna bring them into school tomorrow and Natalie's gonna taste test them and see if they taste good or not. So that's our fun challenge for this week's episode, and let's get started.
I've made chocolate chip cookies a lot of times, so I feel pretty confident in myself that I can make them without a recipe. I know that we usually start with butter and sugar, so let's do that.
I'm just gonna add a stick of salted butter, pour in some brown sugar, about that much. And I'll add a few scoops of white sugar as well. I did about 5 spoonfuls. A little bit of vanilla extract. It's kind of a lot, oops. That seems like enough. And I almost forgot to add some baking soda or powder. I don't know if you're supposed to use baking powder, but I'm using baking soda. Kitchen, and here with me I have Olivia's cookies that she baked. I also have a chart right here to help me critique her cookies. They actually look pretty good, not gonna lie. They look thick and soft. I don't really like hard cookies that are like super thin, so they look pretty good. The cookies don't really look like anything on the chart, but they definitely look like really thick. So maybe she added too much flour. Okay, I'm gonna open it in half and see what the inside looks like. Okay, I'm just gonna go ahead and try it. Okay, they're not bad. They're actually pretty good for not using a recipe or anything. It lacks some flavor, so I feel like she definitely could have used too much flour or like not enough sugar or not enough vanilla. Texture-wise, they're fluffy. I kind of like it when they're more soft and chewy, but this still tastes very good. I think presentation-wise, they look good. They look fine. Personally, I think that the top two on the chart look the most appealing. So it doesn't really look like those two, but I mean, it still looks pretty appetizing. Taste-wise, I think it lacks some flavor. It definitely still tastes like a chocolate chip cookie, so that's a win in my book. Okay, I'm gonna give the overall rating a 6 out of 10. They're not the best, but she didn't have a list of ingredients or measurements, so yeah, I'm impressed. Good job, Olivia. Thanks so much for watching this special week of Livin' That in the Kitchen. Make sure to tune in to our next episode to see us make some sweet sesame chicken. Now on to the next segment.
Hi everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Fashion Mania. As you can see, we are in the studio today because we are going back full-time now at school. The 2021 Oscar Awards happened on Sunday, and so today we're going to talk about the best and worst dress from the award show. My favorite look from the night was Regina King's. She was a presenter at the award show, and she wore this blue Louis Vuitton dress. I love this dress. The sleeves kind of remind me of like butterfly wings, and I'm obsessed with them. The dress makes her look like regal and like a king. She's living up to her name. I love the color and the jewels going down. I'm gonna give this a 10 out of 10. My favorite male look from the night was Lakeith Stanfield. He was nominated for Best Actor in a Supporting Role for his part in Judas and the Black Messiah. And he wore this Saint Laurent suit. I love this outfit. He looks like a disco king straight from the 1970s. I've also never seen this look before. It's so obviously 70s, and I feel like when people usually take inspiration from the past, they do it more subtly, but I really like this. And I feel like it really stood out. He also didn't wear a normal black suit, thank the Lord, because I'm sick of them, but it's also still classy with the black and white. I'm gonna give this another 10 out of 10. And finally, my least favorite look from the night was Laura Dern's. She was also a presenter at the award show and wore this Oscar de la Renta dress. I really do not like this look. She reminds me of the feather duster from Beauty and the Beast, if you know what I'm talking about. I don't like the long sleeve top at all, and then the contrast between the top and the big floofy skirt just makes it worse. I also never really like Laura Dern's looks. I remember from the Oscars last year, I didn't like hers either, so she needs to step up her game. I'm giving this a 4 out of 10. Okay, time for rapid fire. I loved Andra Day's. She looks amazing in this Vera Wang dress. Love Zendaya's. Loved Carrie Mulligan's. I did not like Emerald Fennell's. She was in Gucci. I didn't like Viola Davis's either, which seemed to be an unpopular opinion with the internet. And I didn't like Margot Robbie's hair. All right, thanks for watching this episode of Fashion Mania. See you next time.
Hello, and welcome back to the Writer's Corner. I'm your host, Micaela Carey, and this week we'll be continuing our lesson on story writing. Today I'll be using the information we created last week to start a story based on the prompt. So let's get started. Now, before I start diving into this plot and creating a story out of it, I want to give you a tip. Quick writing can help push your ideas forward and push your insecurities away. Quick writing is as simple as setting a timer for 20 minutes and just letting yourself write. It really helps me push past my doubts, because I don't spend time thinking, is this story good enough? Is this character interesting? I just write. And this can be really helpful if you don't know how to start a chapter or how to start your book. You can just test it out and see what comes out of it. Also, always remember, think before you write. Just like I mentioned in the previous video, I like to plan my chapters so that I know what's going to happen, so I'm not just mindlessly going into it. It's very important to always think before you write. Now I'll read you what I came up with based on the prompt. The sea has always been a mystery to humans. The nature of its depth might never be discovered. Yet despite this, the Lisdale Company began an operation to suck the salt out of the sea. This is because salt has recently gone up in value around the world. And thanks to these money-hungry hearts, the sea was awakened on February 13th, 2021. It was a sweltering 9-degree day, and the beach was full of visitors. For those in the water, it was a disastrous day. The sea came upwards like a tidal wave, and it appeared to those watching with fear that it had a gigantic mouth that made the swimmers disappear within seconds. As the monstrous wave turned from sea green to obsidian, those still on the beach turned and ran, although one young man was not lucky enough to get away. Oscar Hoffman is an anxious man. He's the epitome of weakness. So when Oscar was swept up into the sea, he succumbed to the idea of death. But the world had other plans for him. Within minutes, he was flung hard onto the hot sand, coughing up water. When he opened his eyes, he saw a group of people standing above him with what looked like water guns. We're the WAN, and we like to recruit you, a middle-aged woman spoke. What? What is that? Oscar questioned, clearing his throat. The warriors against Nagania, a young man grinned. I must be dreaming, Oscar said, smacking his head into the sand. The group looked around at each other, scratching the backs of their head. Are you sure this is the guy the man from before whispered? Yes, I am absolutely sure, the woman snapped back. The young man's eyes widened, and he turned his gaze to the ground. When Oscar lifted his head and he still saw the group, his heart began to pound in his ears. This isn't real. We can explain some of this to you at our headquarters, but we must hurry and leave. Nagania wants you, and it will come again if we do not leave, the woman explained. Oscar looked back at the sea and remembered what breathlessness felt like. His head was spinning, and his vision had gone blurry. As soon as he stood up, he wavered. God, why am I saying yes to this? He passed out. That's all for this week. If this inspired you to write a story, which I hope it did, you can always send it to my email, which will be at the end of this video. See you next time.
Hey, how's it going, intern? How you doing?
What are you doing?
Not crying. I was just hanging out looking at things. I don't miss my friend Charlie. That's not why I was out here crying. Not crying. Looking at things. What are you doing out here?
Hunting for ghosts, like you told me.
Oh! Yeah, how's that going?
Not good.
Oh. I should probably run, shouldn't I?
Yeah.
Oh, God.